Assalamu alaikum. Now we are going to discuss animal models in translational medicine part 2. By the end of this lesson, we should be able to number one, detect the factors should be considered in conducting animal models. Number two, to differentiate between phase, predictive and construct validity of an animal model. To realize the target validity in animal models in medicine. To recognize SAMHSA's animal model validity scoring system. To categorize disease simulator in animal models. And to identify the flow chart for developing an animal model using example. Also to realize the three R's and the five freedoms rules in developing an animal model. And the last point, to predict limitations of animal models in translational medicine. There are other factors should be considered also, such as the time course of treatment. In animal models, a treatment is frequently initiated either before or shortly after the disease pathology is initiated. يعني يعتبر prophylactic. غالبا لما بنيجي نعمل animal model زي مثلا بتاع diabetes أو بتاع depression بنبدأ التريتمنت يا إما مع البروسيدور نفسه أو الإندكشن أوف ذا انترفنشن اللي هو بتاع الموديل أو بعد الإيه أسبوع أو أسبوعين، فده بيبقى يعتبر بيعتبروه prophylactic مش بيعتبر treatment لأن in clinical situation a treatment is started after onset of symptoms and clear diagnosis اللي هو يعتبر therapeutic وده يمكن يخلي ان في ان الفارماكولوجيكال effects بتاعه الدراجز اللي احنا بنديها بتبقى اوفر استيميتد ان انيمال مودلز ممكن ده يكون تفسير لان انا بعتبر بدي قبل ما الباثولوجي يحصل بالكامل فيفضل ان انا لما اجي استخدم treatment يبقى اذا بعد الايه بعد ما اتاكد ان الموديل حصل بس مش دايما بنقدر نعمل ده. Animal characteristics and background. طبعا الـ species and strains of animals selected for a particular model need to be carefully selected. يعني مش كل الـ strain أو مش كل الـ species بيحصل فيه نفس الموديل. فلازم أعمل proper selection عشان يديني نتيجة معينة. والدراجز للأسف اللي بتبقى tested مش دايما بيبقى فيه كروس رياكتيفيتي مع الهيومن بمعنى ايه بمعنى ان الادويه احيانا تاثر او الكيميكال سبستنس تاثر او يبقى ليها افكت ان ذا انيمالز لكن لما اجي اجربها على الهيومن الاقي فيها اختلاف مفيش كروس رياكتيفيتي في الريسبونس بتاع دراجز مع الهيومن الايج والجندر والهيلث ستيتس اوف ذا انيمال شود بي ماتشد اس بوسيبل تو ذا كلينيكال سيتويشن بمعنى زي مثلا لو انا فور اكزامبل بعمل موديل اوف الزهايمر ديزيز او اوستيوبروسيس او اللي هو اوستيوارثرايتس ذيس ار ديزيزز اوف اولد ايج او elderly تيستينج نيو دراجز كانديديتس ان يونج انيمالز كان جيف misleading results لما بنيجي نعمل ما بنعملهاش في الالدرلي راتس بنيجي نعمل الموديل اوف الزهايمر او الموديل اوف اوستيوارثرايتس نلاقيه بيعملها في الادلت ريت في حين ان الموديل ده بيحصل في الالدرلي نوت ان يونج فده بيؤدي الى المسليدنج في الريزلتس وده اللي بيخلي في جاب في او بروبلم في ترانسليشنال ميديسن ان الريزلتس كانوت ترانسليتد فروم ذا اكسبيرمنتال فيو تو ذا كلينيكال فيو لان اصلا الايدج والجندر والهيلث ستيت مش ماتشد مع الكلينيكال كونديشن اوف ذا ديزيز Validation of an animal model, there are three types of validity. Phase validity, predictive validity, and construct validity. Phase validity, this is the phenomenological similarity or the looks like, يعني symptoms اللي بتظهر على الانيمال تبقى شبه السيمتومز اللي بتظهر على في similarity هنا between the model and human pathology as regarding the symptoms اللي هي الايزومورفي morphologically أو isomorphy. According to ICD-10-11 دلوقتي بقى في ICD-10-11 symptoms. For example, لو احنا قلنا هعمل model of depression. What are the core symptoms of depression according to ICD-11? For example, anhedonia. يبقى we should measure the level of anhedonia in the model. ده بيتقاس مثلا بالسكروز preference test. يبقى فيه مثلا hopelessness فبقيسه بالdespair في الimmobility time. دي تعتبر phase validity. السيمتوم اللي بيظهر على الرات شبه السيمتوم اللي بيظهر على الهيومن في الايه السيم باثولوجي او السيم ديسيز اللي انا بحاول اعمل له induction by the model. The second validity is the predictive validity. يعني to predict drugs or manipulations effective in animal models to be effective in human. يعني this is a pharmacological or therapeutic view. يعني الموديل بتاعي الانتي ديبريسنس اللي بتخفف الهيومن او بتعمل ريليف اوف ديبريشن ان هيومن هتعمل برضو ريليف ان اوف ديبريشن ان ذا انيمال. فلو زي مثلا انا بدي فلوكسيتين this is an antidepressant in human. It will be also antidepressant أو تقلل symptoms of depression في الموديل اللي أنا بعمله جديد دوت في وبدعي إن هو إيه؟ إن هو animal model of depression. يبقى should be improved أو should be يعني affected by the drugs أو manipulations effective in the human. لو ده مشترك ما بينه وما بين الهيومن this is a predictive validity. The third is the constructive validity. Well, constructive validity is the most important criterion. There is a similar theoretical rationale behind the pathology or the pathophysiology of the disease or the mechanism of the disease in both human and in animal. يعني the pathophysiology لما أجي أدرسه في الرات of the animal of depression هلاقينا زي الباثوفيسيولوجي of depression in human. يبقى السيميلاريتي في الباثوفيسيولوجي او الميكانيزم of the disease this is the construct validity and this is the theoretical rationale behind the disease of the pathology. This is the three important validation of animal model. Although phase validity is proposed to be a major criterion for model evaluation, it is considered a criterion of less importance, especially in appraising an animal model of neurobehavioral disorders, such as schizophrenia model. Why? Because schizophrenia model, the core symptom of schizophrenia is hallucinations and delusions, and this is very difficult or impossible to simulate these symptoms in animals, such as rat or mice. So the lack of phase validity doesn't per se invalidate the model. While an animal model with phase validity has to go through the process of establishing its predictive and construct validity. يبقى لو ما فيش phase validity ده cannot مش معناها ان الموديل انتهى. لا ممكن just the predictive and construct validity can validate the model without phase validity in some neurobehavioral disorders. Target validity وده نوع من ال validation very important لأن the target under investigation should have a similar role in human. For example, beta 3 receptors very important in rodents in energy metabolism but not in human. وممكن يبقى التارجت بتاعي already cannot be applicable in human. فهنا there is no translational medicine between the model and the clinical view. For example, anti-T-cell CD28 antibodies caused severe cytokine storm in human but not in animal models. يبقى cannot be applicable in animal models. So there must be a target validity also. SAMS.2006 has proposed a model validity scoring system consists of five criteria. And this will help to assemble a screening cascade or combination of models which altogether has maximum validity. The first criterion is the species. Looks here, the closer the species comes to human, the more likely its pathophysiology of the disease similar to human, so it will take higher score. So the non-human primate, such as apes or monkeys, will take score 3. Non-human mammals, such as rats or mice, will take score 2, and so on. The second criterion is disease simulation. Here we induce the model by different principles. If the simplest model is to test the drug in healthy individuals in a certain measure. For example, if we test a drug that improve or enhance the memory in rat and use this test to treat Alzheimer's disease. This is very simple, and here there is no induction of the disease by any method. We just test the drug in a certain symptom, which is the memory, in rat, and use it to simulate or to predict the effect in human. This will take one. While if we use a pharmacological, for example, substance to induce Alzheimer, simulate Alzheimer in rats, for example, if we use intraperitoneal injection of scopolamine or another substance like colchicine or OCA injection intracerebroventricular, this will induce cognitive dysfunction. Here we use a pharmacological agent to induce the disease. This will take score 2. If more complex, and a combination of more than interventions, for example, chronic mild stress, we use complex interventions with scheduling to induce this take more score, and so on. But the more complex the method to simulate the disease on human, the higher the score, because it will be more near to the real life or the true. The third criterion is the face validity. Very simple. If we have two or more core symptoms in the animal model, this will take score 4. Core symptom according to ICD-11. Or for example, if neurobehavioral, like DSM-5, core symptom from DSM-5. If one core symptom only, for example, anhedonia in depression, this will take score 3. If we have two core symptoms, take score 4, and so on. Complexity of the test. In vivo is more complex than in vitro or ex vivo, and cellular or subcellular. So in vivo will take more score, which is score 4, while in vitro or ex vivo less score, like 3 or 2, and so on. Predictivity is the effect of the drug or pharmacological agents. If there is a graded dose response from the drug in or all pharmacological agents in this model, يعني a graded dose response, يعني when we increase the dose of the drugs, the more effect in the rate or the symptom will be more relieved. So this is the predictivity. While if graded for certain pharmacological principles and the other no, this will take less score, which is 3. If no graded but only or none, you know, quantile dose response, all or none, produce effect or no effect, this will take score 2, and so on. So these are the 5 criteria for evaluation or scoring the animal model. Can be used to compare animal models, and can be used also to develop or use more than one model to express or translate the effect from animal to human in different aspects. In animal models, we want to mimic or simulate the disease state in clinical. So applying what is called disease simulators. And this table will summarize the categorization of disease simulators. The first category is the genetic. Here we transfer the disease-associated gene into the model system. For example, genetic mutation in familial forms of Alzheimer. Number two, simulated. Here we use external factors so as to induce or mimic the disease state in the model system. This external factor may be physical, toxins, drugs, or genetic. Physical, like, for example, ligation of middle cerebral artery to induce a stroke. For example, applying chronic restraint or chronic exposure to unpredicted chronic stressors so as to induce depression. Toxins like MPTB, destroying dopaminergic neurons in the basal ganglia and induce Parkinson's disease, like model. Drugs, schizophrenia can be induced by amphetamine or phencyclidine model. Also, scopolamine can induce model like Alzheimer's disease. Genetic, in some conditions, gene expression level are changed and these can be mimicked by transgenic mice, like tumor diseases. In studying the tumor, we use the transgenic gene. Here we manipulate the gene expression. Analogues. Here there are several animal species naturally express the condition of the disease, similar to human disease. For example, there is a natural species of diabetes, rats, inbred rats expressing diabetes, here Zucker obese rats. For example, there is a certain species from rats, spontaneous hypertensive rats. Also, there is spontaneous epilepsy. Environmental, like inducing infectious agents like viral infection. There is what's called the LAMB model of syncytial virus infection. LAMB model of syncytial virus infection, respiratory virus infection. Intrinsic, here the intrinsic categorization. It's called the intrinsic because we take cells or tissue or organ or plasma samples from the patients. And this material contains the true disease because they are taken from the diseased human. So reflecting the correct genetic background for expressing the disease. This is called intrinsic. So these are the genetic simulated analogs and environmental and intrinsic categorizations of disease simulation. We will discuss the flowchart, how to develop or build an animal model using NHL model of schizophrenia, neonatal hippocampal lesion model of schizophrenia. Here they inject the excitotoxin in the hippocampus of the neonate and inducing destruction of the hippocampus and a model of schizophrenia. First, this procedure should be evaluated by ethical committee, and this process will be parallel in all every stages of the model so as to revise the 3R rule we discussed before in the first lecture of our course: refinement, reduction, replacement. Also, there is another principle or rule, which is the 5 freedom rule. The animal should be, there is a freedom from thirst, hunger, malnutrition, freedom from suffering, freedom from pain or injury, freedom from any distress or scare, and freedom to express normal behavior. If yes, can the discomfort be justified? If yes, we will go to the next step. step, which is the scientific evaluation for the reliability or replicability. You remember the first replication, which is called the close or the similar replication, copy-paste from the original study. If give the same or there is a consistency in the results, yes, there is a reliability. So we'll go to the next step, which is the descriptive similarity or the face validity of the model. If there is face validity, yani the same symptoms or symptoms like core symptoms or symptoms of the original disease or clinical disease, we will go to the next step. While if there is no or there is a lack of face validity, this doesn't per se invalidate the model. We will go to the next step, which is homologous structures and or the process, which means that there is a structural abnormality similar to the disease. In NHL model, for example, there is a structural abnormality in the hippocampus and the other areas innervated by the hippocampus. So there is a homologous structural similarity. So we'll go to the next step, which is the predictability. If there is no homologous structural similarity in the abnormality or the pathology is similar, so there is no model. This is a fatal point. If there is no structural abnormality similar to the disease, so there is no model. This is a dead end. But if yes, we will go to the predictive validity, the effect of drugs, I have discussed before. If yes, we will go to the construct validity or the sound theoretical rationale, which is the pathophysiology of the disease. In NHL model, the pathophysiology or construct validity here is not satisfactory because the process of the disease here by induction to destruction of the hippocampus, while the pathophysiology of schizophrenia is not well understood. So this construct validity is not well satisfactory here. After this stage, we will go after phase validity, predictive validity, construct validity, we will go to the external validity by generalizability, because all these phase predictive construct, this is internal validity. External validity began from generalizability, and we discussed before by three replication, partial replication, systematic replication, and then conceptual replication. If yes, the model will be biological and the clinical relevance. If no, this model may have limited applicability but will not die. This is the different stages and steps for development of the animal model, internal and then external validity. Animal models, when carefully selected, designed, and conducted, this will be a very important part for any translational drug development strategy to be translate data from the preclinical or experimental to the clinic. After discussing all these stages of animal model development, there are still limitations of animal model in translational medicine. First, the selection bias. Involving young and healthy animals for research always carries a risk of selection bias. Also, the natural dissimilarities between the physiological and the pathological systems of animal models and human, because there is a species variation. So finally, we should ask ourselves, what is the observed range of animal to human translational success and failure rates within the currently available empirical evidence?
Good luck and thank you.